Hello, it's your anchor Gloria welcoming you all to this news episode of Daiji Global Panvision.
Today's telecast is sponsored by
UAE Exchange, world's trusted money transferer.
First, news headlines from abroad. Mataro Sarbela drama leaves audience spellbound at 9th anniversary of Daiji Dubai. Sensational singing idols, comedy king casts magic spell at Indian Carnival at Kuwait. Uswa celebrates 5th anniversary on grand scale. News from Mangalore and around. Historical Bappanadu Rathotsava draws devotees from far and wide. Tuttu Muttu, Book of Limericks by Yashwant DS released. Opposition boycotts BJP's maiden budget session at Mangalore City Corporation. And to entertain you, we have sterling performance by Nirmarga Group during Konkani Nirantari. News in detail. Daiji Dubai, a forum of Konkani writers based in Dubai, has done wonders in promoting and nurturing Konkani in various ways in the last 9 years. By honoring senior Konkani writers with cash award, it is seen that contributions of these stalwarts do not go unnoticed. This year's anniversary too was not an exception to this. While senior writer Eddie Netto was awarded with the prestigious Daiji Dubai Award, Francis Kashia drama Mataro Sarbela, directed by none other than Hemacharya, cast a magic spell on the jam-packed audience. We have an exclusive photo report on this. It was jubilant atmosphere at the Indian High School, Sheikh Rashid Auditorium in Karama for the members of Daiji Dubai, Konkani writers in the UAE and all the Konkani lovers who gathered in a record number to witness one of the best entertainment evenings of the year. For Daiji Dubai Writers Forum, it was the biggest event in the last 9 years. For the 9th consecutive year, a Rs 50,000 cash award was presented to a veteran Konkani writer who has contributed immensely to Konkani literature in particular and language at large. Eddie Netto was the award winner for the year 2007. Melvin Rodriguez, regarded as one of the greatest poet of modern era, received the award on behalf of Eddie Netto, who could not travel from Mangalore due to personal reasons. In a short felicitation program arranged earlier, Walter Nandalike, compeer of the event, read out the Maan Patra, and Joseph Matthias of Marriott Fret Systems, a well-wisher of Daiji Dubai, presented the Maan Patra to Melvin. Melvin Rodriguez received a check of Rs 50,000 on behalf of Eddie Netto from Leo Rodriguez, a well-wisher and sponsor of the event. Frank Fernandez of Moscow Shipping Company, also a well-wisher of Daiji Dubai, presented a memento to the awardee. Hemacharya, conveyor of Daiji Dubai Writers Forum, presented mementos to the main sponsors. During the second part of the event, 3 Konkani books were written by Daiji Dubai members were released. Veteran and popular writer Stanny Pinto's Jikali Solvoni was unveiled by his wife Dinah Pinto. Stanny Pinto is one of the founder members of Daiji Dubai and is popular for his romantic novels like Mogamaka Zolenaka. Daiji Publication has published this book. Kavita Publication has published P.J. Karun Algade's collection of poems Nimani Soirek. Sudhir Shetty, CEO and General Manager of UAE Exchange, released his book. Publisher Melvin Rodriguez was also present on the dais. Another young writer and Daiji Dubai member, Ashok Dias, Shambhur Kirna, was also released by Harish Shergar of ACME Building Materials. In a much-awaited entertainment program, Mataro Sarbela, play written by veteran and famous Konkani playwriter Francis Fernandez Kasha, directed a well-known and experienced director, actor-writer Hemacharya, and produced by Diane D'Souza, was staged which regaled the audience to the fullest. Daiji Rang Mandir members acted in this play, which was presented by Ramni Events. The story conveys true moral. The experienced actors like Avril Rodriguez, Lavina Fernandez, Sunita Menezes, Cynthia Pinto, Veena De Silva, Kelvin De Souza, Deepak De Silva, Paul Almeida, Rajesh De Souza, Robert Fernandez and Diane De Souza contributed their best to bring this play to the professional level. Cyril Baptiste was the backbone of this play with his superb music during the entire play. His work behind the screen was appreciated by the audience. During the interval, sponsors of the event were felicitated with mementos. Hemacharya introduced founder members of Daiji Dubai Writers Forum, while Francis Fernandez Kasha spoke on the occasion and thanked everyone for their support. Hats off to Daiji Dubai and all the best for their future endeavor. Your love for Konkani has surely inspired 1,000 others to tread the path which you have shown. May your tribe increase. Elsewhere in Kuwait, Indian Carnival 2008 was organized by Hot Stepper, the entertainment wing of Creative Indians Association, for the first time in the entertainment city on Friday, March 20th. Not to tell, it was a grand success. Indian Carnival 2008 was organized by Hot Stepper, the entertainment wing of Creative Indians Association, for the first time in the entertainment city on Friday, March 28th. Hot Stepper is a group of employed professional individuals with varied talents and interests who have got together with the aim of promoting entertainment moments for the people of Kuwait with solo group dances, musical gala, sporting events, theoretical performances and other art events. Prashant D'Souza is the president of Hot Stepper, while Vinod D'Souza is the vice president, who have organized several hit shows like Indian Republic Day celebrations, DJ Akhil's Night, DJ Akbar's Night, The Maka Night, Hangama 2007, Indian Carnival 2005, etc. The entertainment city was specially set for the Indian Carnival, which started from 10 a.m. Along with the exciting rides, the day was filled with delicious Indian food prepared by renowned and famous restaurants, loads of free gifts, giveaways, concept face painting, balloons, t-shirt printing, lots of exclusive offers, freebies and gifts from sponsors, amazing music and loads of fun activities. The stage performances started from 4:30 p.m. with group dance competition and live dance performances by the artists. There were 6 senior groups for the dance competition. Jovis Damal, Nach Baliye and Jovis Moja won first, second and third prizes respectively for their dance performances. Performance by Dance Illusions was simply mind-blowing. The sponsors were honored with mementos by Prashant D'Souza, Vinod D'Souza and Wilson D'Souza, marketing sponsor of Creative Indians Association. After the local performances, both the stage and crowd was captured by well-known visiting artists, current Indian Idol lover boy from Shillong, Amit Paul, the youngest artist of the Indian Idol 3, Ankita Mishra, and debut performance in Middle East by the King of Comedy Circus 2007, Vijay Ishwarlal Pawar, better known as VIP for the barrel of laughs that he brings with him. Both Amit Paul and Ankita Mishra were full of energy and vigor as they demonstrated their amazing singing talents. They kept the audience on their feet with super latest hit songs. VIP, who is also aiming to enter the famed book of Guinness Records for his penchant of imitating animal voices, kept the audience highly entertained with his rib-tickling jokes and mimicry. It was a unique opportunity for the Kuwait audience to enjoy a mixture of music, dance, comedy and fun. The program was professionally compared by Kuwait's well-known emcees Lloyd John, Mervin Pereira and Neeta Bhatkar. The event was sponsored by Watania Telecom, Shell Super Plus, Future Communications Company and co-sponsored by Auto One and Kuwait Continental Hotel. It was a whole day of fun and frolic for Mangaloreans living in Dubai. While Daiji Dubai anniversary brought a perfect entertainment package for the evening, they began with the 5th anniversary celebrations of Uswas, an association of Shirwa parishioners spread across UAE. Uswas, an association of Shirwa parishioners spread across the UAE, celebrated their 5th anniversary at the Grand Hotel premises here on March 28, 2008. The day-long program, as promised, turned out to be full of fun and entertainment. Talented artists of Shirwa, not only from Dubai, but also from Doha, were also present to perform on the show. Raj Gopal, noted guitarist from Mangalore, who has lent his musical hand from major sandalwood shows in Karnataka, was a special invited artist flown specially all the way from Mangalore to participate in the event. Joseph Matthias and Alphonse D'Souza were among the main guests. The main attraction of the program was a show called Kon Zatolo Konkani Lakhpati. In between the programs, there were spot prizes and baila dance and couple dance. Local artists entertained the audience with songs. Konkani's short play, Tupe Kotpache Tundurai, was staged. At the end of the program, there was a raffle draw. Songs were also sung by Asha Mabin, Dini D'Souza, Jossi, Tina Sequeira, Kanyut Matthias and others. The vote of thanks was proposed by Manoj Menezes and the entire program was compared by talented young compere Uttam Menezes. The event finally concluded with a grand Kudla Masala by Kanyut and group. That was all the news we had from abroad. Mangaloreans living in the Middle East are indeed doing yeoman's job in promoting and nurturing their mother tongue and native culture. Kudos to them. Now, before moving on to the local news, allow me to take a short commercial break. On the other side of the break, along with the local news, we also have exclusive entertainment for you all. So don't go away, stay tuned.
भरेनार आणि मस्कतार जाई पडल्यात. हाऊस नर्स, हाऊस ड्रायव्हर, हाऊस टीचर्स, हाऊस गार्डनर, ब्युटिशियन, बेबी सिटर्स, सेल्स गर्ल्स, हाऊस मेड्स, अरेबिक कुक आणि हाऊस बॉईज. मुंबईत रावची गावात आवून मुंबई इंटरनॅशनल एअरपोर्टात पाहुची व्यवस्था. इमिग्रेशन, टिकेट आणि मेडिकल सगळे सिलेक्शन मॅनेजर करतात. फोटो सांगता अर्जी धडूंक विळास. सिलेक्शन मॅनेजर, पोस्ट बॉक्स नंबर 1302, मँगलोर 575006. सिलेक्शन मॅनेजर आतां 23व्या वर्सांत.
Trusted Money Transferer.
Welcome back after the break. Shri Durga Parameshwari Temple at Bappanadu near Mulki has historical significance. Traditions say that now famous Bappanadu Temple was built by a Muslim merchant Bappa Bari. This center of religious harmony is known for its annual Rathotsava, which draws devotees from far and wide in lakhs. This year the Rathotsava was held on Thursday, March 27th night. We have an exclusive report on this. The annual Rathotsava of historically famous Sri Durga Parameshwari Temple located at Bappanadu near Mulki here was held with religious fervor on Thursday, March 27. The chariot of the temple was pulled in the stagnant waters of the paddy fields in the presence of sea of devotees who had flocked in from far and near. The residents of neighborhood including temple trustees were doubtful of pulling the chariot on Rathotsava day owing to the unseasonal rains that had lashed across the coastal districts for almost a week. Meanwhile, a few changes were made on the usual path during this year's Rathotsava, mainly owing to stagnant waters at the venue. Tractor was used along with muscle power in order to pull the chariot ceremoniously. Determined youth of local sports club joined by devotees succeeded in pulling the celebrated chariot through the stagnant water.
Thank you.
temple is situated on the banks of Shambhavi River at Pappanadu village of Mulki town. The main deity of this temple is goddess Sri Durga Parameshwari. The place Pappanadu means Bappa's village. As per the legend Bappa, a Muslim merchant is responsible for the temple construction. Pappanadu Dolu, musical drum, is well known and there is a large drum that is kept on the side of the temple. Pappanadu Sri Durga Parameshwari Temple is one of the main Shakti worship centers of the Dakshin Kannada and Udupi districts. Here the main deity is in the form of Linga. Eligibility of Muslims for accepting prasadas of the temple is one of the special features of the Kshetra. Muslims also participate in the temple festivals. Even today, the prasadas of the very first day of the festival is given to the house of Bappa Berry. As said earlier, Pappanadu's dolu or drum is famous. But what makes this religious center really unique is the secular message it carries and amount of non-Hindu devotees who throng here in large number. Tuttu Muttu, a book of Lime Rikes by Yashwan D.S. was released by Chidambara Baikampadi, principal correspondent of Kannada Prabha on Friday, March 29th. Light serves as a symbolic gesture for leading people from darkness to brightness, said Father Jayaprakasha D'Souza, priest of the Mother of God Church. He was speaking at a gathering after inaugurating a function in which Tuttu Muttu, compilation of Lime Rikes authored by Yashwan D.S. was unveiled. The function was held at the Ravindra Kala Bhavan at the University College premises here on Friday, March 28. The world is an absolute darkness and bonds among people are becoming increasingly feeble. Human relationships have started losing their identity. He lamented and hoped that his compilation just released may bring a ray of hope to dissipate darkness from this world. Today, all ears are for BI and IT, with no one having the patience to either read or enjoy the essence of poetry. The compilation may motivate them to read, he hoped. Chidambara Baikampadi, principal correspondent of Kannada Prabha, released the compilation and also spoke on the occasion. Ganesha Prasada Pandelu, sub-editor of Udayavani, presided over the function. It is for the first time that BJP has come to power in Mangalore City Corporation, so a lot is expected from them. However, their first ever budget tabled on Friday, March 29, faced boycott from opposition who questioned the validity of the budget. So it was a tumultuous session of budget at MCC. The first budget session of BJP in MCC turned out to be tumultuous after the opposition boycotted the meet, questioning the validity of budget tabled for the year 2008-2009. Thus, the debut budget of BJP in MCC was presented and approved in the absence of opposition party. It all started with opposition leader Harinath questioning the validity of the budget right at the onset, since an earlier circular sent to them had informed only about general meeting and not about tabling of budget. He was soon joined by other members such as Shashidhar Hegde, Appi, Deepak Pujari and Ashraf. But the Joint Commissioner Ajit Kumar Hegde clarified that budget could be presented in a general meet also as per the Section 43(3) of Municipality Act and mentioned reasons for delay in serving notice. But the opposition was not convinced. In the meantime, Mayor Ganesh Hosabettu asked the Tax, Finance and Appeal Standing Committee Chairperson Ranganath Kinney to present the budget. But as he started, opposition rushed to the well of the House. But when the budget presentation continued, they walked out in protest. We are not done yet. We still have much awaited entertainment section, but after this short commercial break.
ಜಾಗ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ದೋಷ ಈ ದೋಷ ಮನೆ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಫ್ಲಾಟ್ ಅಂತೂ ಮೇಲೇಳುವ ಮೊದಲೇ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬುಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್
ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಹೊಸ ಮನೆಯ ಯೋಗ್ಯತೆ ಎಂದು ತಿಳಿಸ್ತೀರಾ
ಅಪ್ಪ ರಾಮಪ್ಪ ಅಣ್ಣವರ ಸರ್ವ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗೆ ಪರಿಹಾರ ನೀಡಪ್ಪ ಬಾರ್ಲಾ
ಮೂಲಭೂತ ಸೌಕರ್ಯ ಇರುವಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಸಜ್ಜಿತ ಫ್ಲಾಟ್ಗಳ ಖರೀದಿ ಬಾಡಿಗೆಗಾಗಿ ಪಡೆಯಲು ನಮ್ಮ ಸೇವೆ ಸದಾ ಸಿದ್ಧ.
ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಎಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ರಿಯಲ್ ಎಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪರ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್.